Will retargeting die without third-party cookies? How will we advertise products and services on our websites to potential buyers without them? Of all the recent news to come out of Silicon Valley, the most shocking to advertisers and welcomed by individuals who value their privacy was Google's announcement that they would no longer support third-party cookies on their Chrome browser.
Considering Chrome has a global browser market share of over 60%, marketers didn't understand why the company would jeopardize its $180 billion a year income by eliminating individual tracking data that cookies provide. But as their chief executive explained in testimony before the U.S. Congress, people don't like to feel that they're being tracked around the internet.
That raises the question internet marketers are now asking themselves. Will retargeting die without third-party cookies? How will we advertise products and services on our websites to potential buyers without them?
The answer is no. Retargeting will not die. Instead, it will evolve while providing technology-driven privacy guarantees for individual consumers. And evolution will be driven by the concept of cohorts. In simple terms, cohorts refer to a group of people who share similar interests and are prone to frequently visit particular websites.
The key is nurturing these cohorts with both group-based and individual-based approaches in advertising. This means using artificial intelligence like deep learning that will help you market to cohorts, effectively replacing the need for cookies.
Here's how it works. Currently, your targeted audience is identified as an individual by a third-party cookie, which allows for cross-site tracking between an advertiser and a publisher.
So when third-party cookies on Chrome are gone, your audience will still be addressable when they belong to a cohort or an interest group. These are individuals with common defining characteristics or website behaviors.
Take, for example, an individual who wants to buy a new laptop, mouse, and keyboard. And this individual only browses on the website shopnow.com. Deep learning will provide insights into their patterns of behavior and intent to buy more than just the laptop by recommending additional relevant products.
Technology will then assign its individual to a cohort of a laptop lover who intends also to buy a mouse or a keyboard. The future ads they see will still be personalized while maintaining the privacy of individual consumers.
With the demise of the third-party cookie, the browsers will control the privacy-preserving technology that allows it to target an audience in a group-based approach. This introduces a high probability of adaptation by the advertising and marketing communities and the potential to scale upwards.
To sum it up, your future customers will be addressed by on-device interest groups. This group-based approach will be supported by web browsers or subsidiary technologies replacing third-party cookies for individual identification and cross-site tracking.
This will be made possible by using sufficiently powerful technology such as deep learning and advanced algorithms to give you comprehensive and future-proof solutions.
So, to answer the question, will retargeting die without third-party cookies? The simple answer is no, and it doesn't have to be difficult either.
You can find more detailed answers to this and other questions at blog.rtbhouse.com. Stay tuned for more updates, and thanks for watching.